It's a good question, which is divided into two parts. The first part is that what is the hijab of the woman supposed to be? The second part, what is the hijab of the man? Well, some claim that as long as a woman, if I wear my proper hijab, pull the abaya, cover my face, wear the gloves, this is the proper hijab, and this is how it's supposed to be. You know, and that's the important part, and that's it. As long as I'm wearing this hijab, I am gaining the highest of statuses in the Day of Judgment. And some say, well, the hijab is in the heart. It's not supposed to be like black or abaya or whatever. It can be any kind of hijab, even if it shows details, as long as my religion is in the heart. I pray on time. I obey Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. In fact, it's mixed of both things, two things. The proper hijab is the inner state, the spiritual state that shows on the outside. What I see outside, is what, when you see a doctor, when you see him wearing a certain clothes, a certain suit, that tells that he's a doctor. When I see a person who's working in construction, he wears the high-vis, the hard hat, the shoes, the boots, because he works in construction. So what is shown outside is supposed to speak about what's inside. Fatima al-Zahra, salawatullahi wa salamu alayha, when Rasulullah asked, what's best for women? She said, خَيْرٌ لِلْمَرْأَنْ لَا تَرَى رَجُلُ وَأَنْ لَا يَرَاهَ رَجُلُ. The best for the woman is that she should not see a man and a man should not see her. What does that mean? Does it mean that this is the wajib hijab? No. This is the perfect and the highest level of hijab. The more faith I have, the more hijab I, the more like covering of my body I do. So the hijab is what covers the body and doesn't show the details. Okay, and it doesn't attract the sight of the men. Why in the Quran Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَبَرَّجْنَ تَبَرُّجَ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ. Some people think that tabarruj, it means only putting makeup. The word tabarruj, it's issued and it's extracted from the word burj. Burj means tower. Now wherever you go in Sydney, you see that Westfield Tower in the city. When you go to Canberra, there is a big tower as well that you see from very far away. This is considered a tower. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says لا, لا تبرجنا. التبرج is considered everything that attracts the opposite side. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this hijab wajib upon the woman. Even if I'm not convinced, I have to fulfill it as a duty. So the wajib hijab is what covers the beauty of the woman from the body or the face. You know, that doesn't show details and doesn't attract the sight of the opposite gender. While the man, we have a lot of narrations that speak about the hijab of the man. Some say, well, the hijab of the man is the inner hijab. He's supposed to only lower his gaze. You know, the hijab is greater than that for the man. There are narrations that speaks about the shorts, the short clothing that's above the knee. It says, يُذْهِبُ الْمُرُوءَ. It takes away your aura. You won't have aura anymore. Aura as in A-R-D-O-U-R. I don't know if it has another word in English. The shorts. Or, for example, like going outside topless or wearing like singlets. This is not a proper hijab for the mu'min. The mu'min as well, as I said, the doctor has a certain suit. The mu'min, what is outside speaks about what's inside. Why? The more mu'min the man becomes, you will see that he always wears a shirt. He dresses modestly, in a modest way. Why is that? Because he's a mu'min. The more faith he gets, the more haya, shyness he will have. And this is, brothers and sisters, this is the way you support sahab al-asr al-zaman. We take it from his tongue. Walaikum salam wa rahmatullah. We take it from his tongue. Who wants what's best for the community? Sahib al-Asr al-Zaman. He wants this community to be ready for him to reappear, to come back. So when he does dua for you as Shia, he does dua in a way that this is how, Ya Allah, this is how I want the people to be so I can come out. He says in his dua for the Shia, Allahumma wa tafaddal ala shabab bil inaba wa tawba. Oh Allah, grant the youth, the young men, with repentance and going back to Allah. وَتَفَضَّلْ عَلَى النِّسَاءِ بِالْحَيَاءِ وَالْعَفْءِ. And grant the woman with chastity and shyness. So the hijab for the woman, the maximum. So فاطمة الزهراء صلوات الله وسلامه عليه said, it doesn't mean that you have to be like that. It means that it's never enough. A lot of people say, well, I cover my head with the scarf and that's enough. The religion says, no, it's never enough. The more, the merrier. The more covering your hijab is, the better. And for the man, is to lower his gaze, is to يكف شره عن not to mix even not to mix with the opposite gender. A man, one of the companions of Imam al-Baqir صلوات الله وسلامه عليه, he used to teach Quran, and those who attended the lecture in Dar al-Hussein, they heard the story. He used to teach Quran. He's a mu'min. He's one of the companions of Imam al-Baqir. One of the women, she attended the class of Quran, and one day he said like, I started to speak, and then she spoke a word, and then we laughed. It was just a joke. And then days passed, and the story became in the past, and I saw Imam al-Baqir, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. I went to Hajj, I visited Imam al-Baqir. When I visited him, I entered his house, he didn't look me in the face, and he was upset with me. And I said to him, oh master, why are you treating me like this? He said, بأي شيء ما زحت تلك المرأة في ذلك اليوم. What was the reason that you made a joke with that lady last time? Didn't you know أنه لا ينال أمرنا إلا بالورع? That our cause cannot be achieved except with abstinence. The way you reach piety, the way you reach the status where you are an obedient person to Allah and to us is through abstinence. ورع, which is greater than taqwa. Taqwa is I see the sin and avoid it. While abstinence and ورع is I even avoid the introduction of the sin. I do not present in a place where I have to mix with the opposite gender, where I have to joke with the opposite gender. So the man's chastity as well, the man's hijab is this. I hope this answers your question. Salah ala Muhammad wa Ali.
I'm not finished.
Ladies, for the youth. For the ladies, we have the program with Hajj Shahnaz. So make your way to the hall. Okay, from there. There is custard there, hot custard. Go get one cup and go to the hall.